Hello friends, welcome to the lecture series of subject Special Purpose Vehicle. Myself Professor Lav Patel from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology Auto Managing Department. So in today's lecture we will see about the second chapter, that is principle and design consideration for special purpose vehicle. Specifically in this chapter we will see about different kind of systems like braking system, steering system, hydraulic control system. So we will see about this system and how the system are going to affect my overall special purpose vehicle based on its performance, that we will see. So in today's lecture we will see about the braking system. See, we all know about the different kinds of brake that we are using nowadays, from the drum brake, disc brake, vacuum brake, air brake or pneumatic brake. So there are several kinds of brakes that we are using nowadays. Particularly in this lecture we will see about mainly two type of brakes. First, that is the hydraulic brakes, in which we are using different oil, while second we will see about the pneumatic brake, in which we can see the air or how the actual compressed air is going to work with my overall braking components. So basically in this lecture we will see about braking system for special purpose vehicle. See, for braking system or the principle of braking system for individuals like two-wheelers, four-wheelers and special purpose vehicle, the principles are same. So we can say that again, with similar to our cars, we are using same kind of braking system or hydraulic system that we are using. In this system you can see that the braking system, that is an arrangement of various linkages like master cylinder, hollow tubes, pedal, then booster mechanism, caliper. So there are several linkages and components that are arranged that in such a fashion that it converts the vehicle's kinetic energy into the heat energy. Like by applying brake we will generate friction, and due to that friction heat is going to generate, and that energy which turns to stop or decelerate the vehicle. So basically the braking system, the requirement of braking system is to stop the moving vehicle or special purpose vehicle to decelerate or lower the speed for stable parking of vehicle either on a flat surface or on a slope, as a precaution for accidents and to prevent the vehicle from any damage due to the road condition. So basically we are using our braking system for these kind of purposes. Moving further, if we are talking about hydraulic brakes, so this is a basic diagram of hydraulic brake, in which you can see that the foot pedal is there. By using foot pedal, from the master cylinder the oil gets compressed. Generally we are using non-compressible fluid or oil for braking system, and from master cylinder that oil goes to individual cylinder, to the wheel cylinder, and with the help of compressed oil the wheel cylinder gets extracted and the brake is going to apply. So this is my basic principle for hydraulic system. Furthermore we will see about the actual operation of master cylinder, in which you can see that the push rod is there, which can be operated with the help of foot pedal. Two outlets are there, and also fluid reservoir or brake fluid reservoir is there, which is mounted on the top of the assembly. From this assembly you can see that it is a diagram of tandem master cylinder. The red color fluid has been shown in the figure. Two inlet ports that are shown in the video. Also compensating ports to brake vacuum or to brake the bubbles, we are choosing compensating ports. Also secondary ports, retaining spring, piston seal, that arrangement should be there. Now while applying forces, there are two springs that has been attached and two outlet. One outlet goes to the frontal wheels and the another outlet that goes to the rear wheels. Now while applying brakes, first compensating port is going to be closed and the pressure is going to build up, and that fluid pressure pushes the second piston. See, the red portion shows the maximum pressure. Again at the second compensating port that is going to be closed after the first, and again the fluid is going to be pressurized and that brake fluid goes to the calipers, the same calipers that we are using in four wheeler or two wheelers. The principle is same. So this is the operation, and while releasing, for breaking the vacuum, the compensating port was there from which the oil should come to the compression chamber from the reservoir. So for that we are choosing this assembly of master cylinder. Now moving further, let us see about the pneumatic braking. See, there are our special purpose vehicle is very large and a huge vehicle, and to stop that we need some strong braking mechanism. So for that, one of the strong braking mechanism, that is my pneumatic braking system, or we can say that air braking system. So in this we are using compressible air to brake the special purpose vehicle. So a pneumatic air brake, a pneumatic brake or a compressed air brake system, that is a type of friction brake for vehicle in which compressed air. So here we are using compressed air, and compressed air has been produced with the help of compressor. That pressing on a piston that is used to apply the pressure to the brake pad and needed to stop the vehicle. So this is my basic principle for pneumatic braking. So we are using compressed air with the help of compressor, and with the help of that compressed air we are applying pressure to the brake pad and needed to stop the vehicle. So the air brakes that work using compressed air instead of hydraulic brake, hydraulic fluid. So that is my big difference with respect to hydraulic brake and pneumatic brake. Air brakes can be either drum brake or disc brake or combination of both. Also the air is pressurized by an engine mounted compressor. So again the engine power, the compressor can be run with the help of partial engine power, which can be attached with the help of belt or chain. The air compressor then pumps the air into the air storage tanks in which the compressed air is going to be stored, and which store the compressed air until it's needed. So this is my basic principle for pneumatic air. So here one schematic diagram for air brake system or pneumatic system that has been shown in the figure, in which you can see that air filter is required because we are using air, and we all know that air is having different dirt particles or sand particles. So to prevent our system to break down, we are choosing air filter at front. So from the air filter the compressor is there. So again, as I have said, the compressor is going to be run with the help of engine power. Again after the compressor, unloader valve is there. See, the main principle of unloader valve is to build the pressure in compressor. So let us say few pressure has been built up in my compressor, and after such limiting pressure it is going to release my air. So at certain pressure unloader valve is going to lift or open. So due to that, what will happen, our compressed air that is transported or that is supplied to the reservoir. So here reservoir tank is there from which the compressed air should be there. Again if the compressed air pressure is going to be reduced, again the unloader valve is closed and compressor has to run until it reaches its predefined pressure. So after reservoir, some pressurized air is going to use for operating accessories, while the majority of compressed air that has been used for brake valve, and with the help of brake valve the caliper is going to be operated and brake has been applied. So this is the main principle and working of pneumatic braking system. Also we can say that there are few advantages and disadvantages of pneumatic systems. Like the supply of air is unlimited, so the brake system can never run out of its operating fluid as a hydraulic brakes can. Air brakes are effective even with the considerable leakage. So here we need not worry about the leakage, while in hydraulic system if you find any leakage you need to replace it or do proper maintenance. So in this kind of brake, small amount of leakages wouldn't mind our braking system. Also, the compressed air inherent in the system can be used too for accessory applications that hydraulics not appropriate for, such as air horns and seat adjusters. So these are the accessories that can be helped with the compressed air also. Now moving further to the disadvantages, like there are a few disadvantages of this heavy system, like air brakes generally cost more because of the heavy components and the number of components that we are using in pneumatic system is very large compared with hydraulic system. Also, air brake system compressed air which results in moisture that requires air dryers to remove. See, while using air filter, you will find such moisture in air content. So for that we need air dryer. So again, one component has been added to my system and again the cost will rise up. That increases the price for air brake system. Learning to operate air brakes smoothly has a learning curve, as they are difficult to operate smoothly. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you.